Hi, my name's Dr. Padilla, and I am a professor in computer science and psychology. I've been a faculty member for over 5 years, and I have seen hundreds, if not thousands, of applicants. And I've been doing a series of videos that have been a little bit of professional development advice for students considering applying to graduate school and helping them to be as successful as possible. As part of this series, I wanted to do a video that is a little bit more existential, if you will, and it is about understanding if you are ready for graduate school. And you might be asking this question, am I ready for graduate school? Now, I can't answer that question for you. That is a very personal question, but I can give you some questions to think about that could help you determine if you think this is the right time for graduate school or if you do ever want to pursue it at all. So the first thing I'd like you to think about when deciding if you would truly like to go to graduate school, and this applies for all different departments and industries, is do you need a PhD? A lot of times you don't. Truthful answer is that for most jobs, you do not need a PhD. You do need a PhD if you're going to be a professor like myself. It's the best job in the world. I highly recommend it to anyone, but it's not for everyone. It truly is not. And that represents a very small proportion of the jobs that are available, and they're available to the top candidates. So you have to be aware of that fact that being a professor is a hard road to toe. But certainly people can do it. I can do it. You know, I'm not a genius or anything. So certainly you could do it if you wanted to. But that's a job that requires a PhD. Not all jobs do. It might be sufficient for you to get a master's degree, which is really great as well. Or maybe you don't need any type of graduate degree whatsoever. So first thing you want to think about is, do I actually need a PhD? And the answer might be no, or it might be yes. A reason you might want to get a PhD if you don't need one is simply because you find it fascinating. Don't have to do everything you need to do in your life. You could do things just because you enjoy it, and it might be fun to get a PhD. The whole process is not entirely fun, but it is truly very rewarding having this scholarly journey. And I know lots of people who apply who certainly don't need one, but simply because that is something that they want to do because they have an inherent desire. Maybe they want to have a doctorate, or maybe they just want to be engaged intellectually. And that is a great reason as well. But just keep in mind that you don't need one, you want one. And that's a good reason too. If you want it, heck, go for it. The next thing I want you to think about is, do I know enough about the field that I'm applying to commit to it to long term? And this tends to be what happens with applicants is, for example, I have a very specific niche of research that I do. I study data visualization, in particular, visualizations with uncertainty. Very, very specific. So I often get applicants who are fantastic, great applicants, strong students, but they've never studied what I study in the way that I've studied it before. I'm not saying that they should have all of the skills. We can, you know, train a great deal of things, but the threat is that they won't like it. The type of work that I do is very esoteric, and it's truly not for everyone. So you need to know enough about the field that you're getting into to know for sure, without a shadow of a doubt, that you can commit to it for quite a while. We're talking 5 to 6 years. And this isn't really something where you can switch midway. As I've talked about in this channel, you often apply to work with a specific professor or lab, and your work is often defined by what they do, and often what they do is very, very specific. So getting them to change route is incredibly hard, or not studying exactly what they study is incredibly hard. So you need to know enough about the field that you're applying to be able to strongly commit to it. And you need evidence that you will like it, because there has been so many students that I've seen who swear up and down that they love this type of research and it's what they want to do, but then they start doing it in a year and they don't like it and they have to change programs entirely. And that is very challenging. So to be ready, fully ready for a PhD program, you need to know enough about that field, ideally have experience in that field to be comfortable to commit to it for a long term. Okay, the next thing is, do you have all the prerequisites? That is, of course, very important and maybe goes without stating, but there's different ways to do this. I have moved from different departments over the years, and people always ask me how I do that. The truth is that I don't just, you know, start in a new department without any catch up. What I have to do is catch up, and that always requires doing the prerequisites necessary for that particular department or job. So when I switched from an art major, because I have a master's in art, to a PhD in cognitive neuroscience, I took several graduate courses in cognitive neuroscience to catch up before I even entered the program. And I read, you know, hundreds of papers, and I worked in labs for several years to make sure I knew that that was the program for me. So with that said, in any field, even if it's the field that you have done your entire undergrad in, you need to make sure that you have the prerequisites in line to be successful in that particular department. Each department has different flavors of the work that they do, so you want to make sure that you are in good position to enter in strongly into that program. That is something that they will evaluate you on independently for each department or field, is does this person have the prerequisites in terms of technical skills or writing skills, the other types of skills that they value, to be successful in their department. That is what they're thinking in their mind. So what you want to do is make sure that you have the prerequisites to be strong in that particular field. That might mean having to do extra classes that don't count for anything. They're just kind of catching up and demonstrating that you in fact do have all the prerequisites, which is what I've done many times. Okay, the next thing you want to think about in terms of deciding if you're ready to apply to PhD programs is to ask yourself, am I a competitive candidate? As I've talked about on this channel several times, when you're applying to PhD programs, the funding is a little interesting. So there's not unlimited funding. Usually each professor can only accept a certain amount of students each year, and maybe every other year, depending on how their funding is. So you're not just applying to a department that has 6 spots. You might be applying to work with a professor who has 1 spot and might get 30 applicants. So you might feel like you're ready in terms of, you know, that you're, this is what you want to do, but you might not be competitive just yet. So things that would make you competitive are: how does your CV look in terms of, do you have any peer-reviewed published papers where you're an author, co-author on? Do you have any patents? Do you have any awards? Have you presented at any conferences? Have you brought in any grant money? If the answer is no to all of those, you're not as competitive as other people. And it changes, you know, based on the ranking of the school, of course. But middle to top tier schools, all of the top rank applicants usually have 1 published paper. Which is a pretty, you know, high bar to reach, and it varies from department to department and the publishing standards of independent fields. But by and large, you're looking at people who have already been publishing research. That's not the case at every place, but just keep that in mind. If you're ready now to apply to schools, but your CV isn't there, then what you might consider doing is volunteering or applying to work at various labs in your area to build up those skills to be a stronger, more competitive applicant. And you can both volunteer at labs. Often labs have post-undergraduate research positions. They might have a lab manager position available to you. All those are ways that you can demonstrate that you will be more and more competitive if you're ready now, but maybe your CV isn't quite ready. And I think the last and maybe the most important thing is, are you really excited? I hope you are. If you're thinking about applying to graduate school, it can seem very daunting and overwhelming. I think what I often hear students saying is, it's such a long commitment. 5-6 years is a really, really long time. If you apply to any other job, you could quit the job in a month. You could do that in a graduate school, but most people don't. They commit for the long term. And that is a huge commitment. It's kind of like getting in a short-term marriage with someone where you have to find this person, they need to like you, and the relationship has to be good, and they have to support your research, and then you have to go to school, etc. It can feel very, very overwhelming. So you need to be excited, especially when you are starting out. You need to feel driven and motivated to do it. And if you are really excited, maybe it is the right time for you to apply. I've been excited and nervous when I was applying, in part because I just didn't think I was good enough. I didn't think I was smart enough to be accepted into these programs. So I knew I was really passionate and I desperately wanted to be involved, but I just didn't think anyone would pick me, frankly. And I was just floored by the amount of positive feedback I got through that process. That makes me really excited now that I was, you know, still here, still in academia. And I think it's an important thing that has really pulled me through the whole process and made me help keep my steam up when things get low. The truth is there's going to be a 5-6 year period, and there will be times that will be very hard for you. We often say, if you don't cry at least once during your PhD, you're not doing it right. And I cried many, many times. So there's going to be hard parts, there's going to be great parts, but having this excitement or love or sincere interest in the work that you're doing needs to be able to pull you through. If you don't have that, if you're just sort of unsure, you might not need to do a PhD. It might not be for you. PhDs aren't for everyone, truly, but you really want to be confident about your choice going in, because it is a big commitment, both from you and also all the people who are investing time and energy into your career success. So you want to be in the best position possible. I hope this was helpful. I am so excited for more people to apply to PhD programs. I think it's a very rewarding experience. And even if you're not ready now, maybe you will be in a few years. Hopefully this video has helped you think about preparing and some of the internal questions that you should ask yourself. If you have any more questions, please let me know. You can comment down below if you have specific questions, and I'll try to address them in follow-up videos. And thank you so much for watching, and take care.